So you want us just to come in?
No, I'll call action.
Okay. Oh gosh, how fun.
Action, yes.
So where are we?
Oh, well, this is Goward House. Haven't been here in 22 years.
Yeah, since we were married in this room. It seems smaller.
Yeah.
I don't know how that is.
It seems bigger because there's no people in it.
Yeah, but there was so many lovely people in here.
Musicians were here. The singers and Maureen Dorothea.
Valoni. We're in Victoria, British Columbia, at the Goward House.
At the Goward House.
I'm not exactly sure when I first met Maria Adaskin, but it would have been in 1991 when my quartet first moved to Victoria. I believe he and Dorothea, his wife, were likely in one of our audiences right away. It was a very much a professional beginning, but very early on, of course, we were in his home, and, you know, just the rest, he became family to us.
He was one of the sweetest persons I've met. He incredible gentle and kind of optimism about him.
Warm, and always had a great sense of humor, and a person of great generosity and integrity. I imagine that there was a conversation where I would have loved to have had a piece of his, and he said, I have this lovely wedding toast. And I know from Dorothea that it was originally for piano and voice, but then he arranged it. So it was a beautiful gift that he really gave to us.
So what is the instrumentation?
It's for a string quartet
and a singer. Soprano.
Soprano. Yeah. Music is extremely sincere.
I liked his music always. I think it's have something funny in it, as well as the serious part is quite serious, but it's never dark. And I thought that's kind of a very charming thing about it.
Yeah.
Musically and technically, I always thought that there's something that strike me the first time I heard and played Murray's music. That it was all about the intervals. Mm-hmm. And never note after note is always a fifth and a fourth and down an octave. Yeah. And it jumps up and down.
Right.
Yet it doesn't feel like you're jumping.
No, there's a long line to it always,
My day bathed in sunlight. And by night illuminated from within.
I would say a wedding toast is very indicative of the humanity that I always feel in Murray's music. That sense of connectedness to nature in all of Murray's music, I think, really just comes to the fore in this lovely piece, because it's describing so many things that are from the Northwest. The salmon, the river, the Douglas firs.
Yeah.
What kind of emotions come back?
Well, just happiness.
Happiness.
A lot
what
of happiness.
What a lovely day it was. And
a tinge
blessed.
Of sadness, because so many of them are gone by now.
Yeah, so many of the people.
Not many, but some of them. Our parents.
Some key players. I just remember feeling, of course, when you're involved in a wedding, there's a million things, but just thinking what a special thing to have something of Murray's in our wedding.
May the heron carry news of you. To the heavens. your twin thoughts spiral upwards like leafy vines, like fiddle strings in the wind, and be as noble as the Douglas fir.
In the Jewish tradition, you have to break something to make
mazel
the marriage. So the mazel
yeah.
tov, and you break a glass, and it says, this time try something else. Don't break it, but keep it. And every time you have a fight, after you're done, and you hold in
you
good terms and
out.
Figure it out, put a little bit of wine and drink together from the same cup. And
yeah.
we still do it.
Yeah.
Until today, and it's...
Well, and we even use
so
it...
So far it worked.
Yes, it has, 22 years later. And we use it for celebrations, too.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes something
yeah.
very special has happened, and we say we want to mark this in that special way, so...
Yeah, so it's a very special cup.
May you never find yourselves back to back without love.
So shall we do a toast?
Oh yes,
we should do a toast.
Means.
Yeah.
To Murray.
Yeah.
I only shook it up. Oh, great.
All right.
Oh, more.
There we go. You first.
Okay. To Murray and
to
the
Murray
wedding toast.
And the wedding toast. Mm.